Good morning and welcome to the Bowling University studio from the International Bowling Campus in Arlington, Texas. I'm John Karabatsis and I'll be your host for this edition of the Bowling University Tuesday Morning Profit Break. Thank you for joining us. The Tuesday Morning Profit Break is an opportunity for sharing insight on how to grow revenue, reduce costs, and enrich yourself, your team, and your business. Welcome to our new viewers and welcome back to those of you joining us again. Thank you for taking a few moments out of your busy day. We have another great show ready to share with you today. So grab your cup of coffee or your favorite morning beverage and let's get started improving your profitability. Today, we're joined by marketing guru, Bart Berger. As you know, Bart was the vice president of marketing for the Brunswick Bowling and Billiards chain before joining the BPA. He's well-versed on today's topic, foundations for digital marketing success. This morning, Bart will be discussing the importance of social media. Bart, welcome.
Thank you, JK, and good morning. And good morning, everyone. Guru might be a bit strong, but I do have some great stuff I want to share with you. So thank you for taking a few minutes to be with us today as part of our digital marketing. I want to spend some time talking about social media and how you can use social media to help grow your business in this digital marketing channel. So let's jump in and get started there. As I always do, I want to take just a minute and kind of ease the tension here when we talk about, you know, digital and marketing in the same sentence there, because many of us as small business operators, we don't consider ourselves IT folks. So it's, you know, we can be a little intimidated by technology or some of the channels that are out there. And I want to ease that for you because you really can be very active in this digital space and in digital marketing. So let's start off first with what is actual digital marketing. It's nothing more than content delivered through digital channels, such as search engines, website, social media that we're gonna talk about today, email marketing, and SMS marketing, which is text message, short message service there. So know this, digital marketing and the technology behind digital has really leveled the playing field. It's made it where we can be very active in that space, just like many of the bigger brands. And the example I like to use is that of mass marketing. Mass marketers, big brands, multi-unit organizations, they can afford things that, quite candidly, you and I probably can't in print, in radio, in TV spots, 30-second, 15-second TV spots that can be shown even on your local cable system. All of those things, for most of us, are pretty cost prohibitive, and they take a lot of effort, energy, and resources that as small business operators, many of us just don't have the time, the expertise, or the budget for. But along comes digital, along comes technology, and it levels the playing field. It really allows us to do the same thing that other brands do. In fact, I like to, internally at the university, I speak to the folks when they come in and say, you can play in the big boy sandbox. And what I mean by that is this, anything that Starbucks does, you can do in your digital channels for your unique individual location. Anything that a big brand like Best Buy does, and those are world-class brands, you can do anything they can do in that digital space, and quite candidly, you can do it just as well. Now, you'll never compete with them in the mass media space. You'll never be able to buy the TV spots or the ads or the radio or all the things that they do, but you can absolutely compete with them in the digital space. So let's talk about how. First, data is king. If we are going to be in this space and compete with the big boys and be in that big boy sandbox, we have to understand that it starts with data. We have to have data from our guest or prospective guest in being able to get in these channels. So I always start with this. Are you collecting data? I hope you are. If not, you need to start today. And if so, how? How are you collecting data both in person in the center or even through your various digital marketing channels? How are you collecting that data? And then once you have the data, the question becomes, where are you going to store it? Where does it reside? What is your CRM solution? And CRM, don't be intimidated by the technology and the acronym. CRM is Customer Relation Management System, or that's really a fancy marketing term for a database. And that database could be as basic and simple as Excel, and there's nothing wrong with that, or it could be as complex as a third-party CRM solution, and there are thousands available. But I would just like to point out that if you're looking for a solution and you want a great place to get started, BPA has a product, Customer Connect, powered by Salesforce. Salesforce is an incredible brand. We're happy to be partnered with them on this. And it may be something that you want to take a peek at. So let's talk about the ecosystem. There's your wonderful center. And these are the five digital channels that we speak to here at the university, both through our Profit Break episodes and online and in person, all the different mechanisms. They include things like website, SEO, or search engine optimization, email marketing, SMS, which again, that's text message marketing. And today what we're going to talk about is this space of social media. And look, there's probably nothing that has changed the very fabric of society more than the proliferation of social media. But I want to talk about, as small business operators, how do we use that to help our business and what are some quick tips going forward there. So, this space of social media, it can give you a headache. I mean, there are lots of channels, many different choices, and where do I start, and which one do I use, and I always hear about these new ones there. Well, I want to keep it simple for you as a small business operator and where you go. Look, Facebook. I want to talk about Facebook from a business standpoint, not about what yours or mine personal feelings, positive or negative, might be about Facebook, but know this. Facebook is the 800-pound gorilla, all right? Don't chase the latest social media fad. What we're going to recommend is, as a small business operator with limited resources, limited time, and sometimes limited funding, pick one channel and do it very, very well, right? You want to fish where the fish are. You don't want to go out and chase the latest fad, the Snapchat or whatever someone's coming out with that says all the kids are there. You want to do the next late greatest thing. It starts and stops with Facebook. How do I know? Because here's what the data shows us there, okay? And I would encourage you to come back to this slide and pause this later and really digest this, but I'm gonna spend just a minute on right now because this is specific to bowling. This was a study that was done of bowlers, and we had them in the four groups, moms with kids in the household, Hispanic, millennials, and Gen X. And look at what the results showed us. Facebook, Facebook, Facebook. Overall, Facebook was at 92%. That dwarfed anything that even came close to that, followed by Pinterest and Instagram. It's interesting. In the general population, it would be a little bit inverted, but in our bowling space, that's what the data says. So some folks may say, well, millennials aren't going to Facebook anymore. They're fleeing. Well, no, that's not what the data says for bowlers. Well, Gen X, you know, they're not there, or mom with kids, they're not there. Everyone is there. It is the 800-pound gorilla. Be a part of it in doing that. Not that we have anything against the other channels, but again, be strategic. You have limited resources, limited time. Fish where the fish are. Oh, and by the way, that one that's number three, Instagram, Facebook owns that. So you could absolutely be a part of that as well there. So fish where the fish are there. So some quick tips for you. It's all about sharing. I want you to share the love. Sharing is caring, okay? We want our guests to be advocates. And there's some quick tips for you to think about that. So what are the characteristics of a highly shareable post? If you're gonna post, and remember, we don't want Facebook to be your website. Your website is not shareable in that sense. But so what are those characteristics? One that gives offers, discounts, contents. Sometimes it advises, it gives tips and how-tos. It warns. Sometimes it can be a warning about problems affecting everyone. That has nothing to do with your product, right? If this is a personal relationship and you want folks to share, it may be a warning about the weather or something that has nothing to do with your product. It amuses, right? We love funny pictures and the cat videos and the dog videos and the funny dog and pet pictures. It could inspire someone. It could be inspirational quotes, you know, whatever that might look like. And it could be amazing, facts, pics, videos about that. And just know that video is king. Video is king in this space right now. And also we want something that unites. It brings us together for a common good. There are too many divisive things out there right now. And boy, you know, anything you can do in bowling, such a uniting, all-inclusive product, you have the ability to do that. So those are some quick tips on what is a shareable post, because it's not just about selling. It is about connecting and getting things that are shareable there. Now, quick tip number two, folks often ask, well, how many times should I post? You know, what does that look like? How many on the business page? On a personal page, we might post with great frequency, or you might just use to check on the kids and the grandkids once in a while. But from a business standpoint, the best practice says that you should be a minimum of 3 times, but no more than 10 times per week. And there's some great examples of how to communicate, the funny baby, the old Ron Burgundy, just things to encourage folks to be thinking about your product, not necessarily with selling direct. Now, here's the one thing most folks don't realize. Facebook wants you to succeed. Now, while they control your page and they have complete ability to shut you down at any time, they want you to be successful from a business standpoint, because if you are successful, it generates more ad revenue for them, and it generates more data for them. So they want you to be successful. So know that they have created some tools specifically for small business operators like you to help you get started. And it's called Facebook for Business. So if you go to facebook.com/business, there is a great website that they have built out, not for big brands. This is not where Best Buy is going to go. They've got their own resources. This is where you and I are going to go to learn more about how to be successful as a small business. And one of the tools they have within there is called Facebook Blueprint. And Blueprint is a great resource to help you understand how to remain active both in a organic and both in a paid session. They've got videos, they've got insights, a lot of great information there as you think about, well, I'm not real versed on Facebook, I don't know what to do. I wanna encourage you to do one thing and do it really, really well. You're gonna be tempted to chase, you know, people talking about Snapchat. You're gonna be tempted to feel like you need to be on Twitter. You're gonna be tempted when someone says that this is the latest and greatest channel that we should be in. And there's nothing wrong with those channels, but given who we are and the resources we have, this is probably where we need to be, and we need to focus on that for now. And it could change in the future, but for now, this is where we wanna be. As always, I just want to remind you, we've got a great 30-minute program online that takes a much deeper dive that you can check out anytime. It's our online, on-demand education and training program. We have a course specifically for just digital marketing Facebook that takes a much deeper dive. And as always, you can think about attending one of our one-day boot camps that happen around the country, or you might even want to come see us here at the studio at the campus and attend one of our five-day programs. In any event, you've got lots of tools to start that journey on your digital marketing and stick with Facebook to get started. JK?
Right. Bart, thank you. Some great stuff, great insight. I want to focus a little more, go back and ask you a couple of questions on Facebook, because that seems to be a big part of the presentation. You mentioned about focusing your efforts on Facebook. Does that mean we shouldn't worry or bother with something like Instagram or Twitter?
You know, I think we, JK, we have to fight the urge, because we are attracted to new things. We're attracted to shiny penny and things that are trendy. And unless you have a large staff and resources that you can, you know, some people outsource, larger businesses will outsource their social media. And if you're outsourcing and paying for it, and I'm paying a third party, I would demand that they're a part of Instagram. I would demand they're a part of Pinterest. I would demand that because I'm paying for all those resources. But as small business operators that have limited funds and limited time, I think less is more. And if you are really good at Facebook, the data just shows that's where people are. So that's where I kind of draw the distinction. I have nothing against those other channels. They can be very worthwhile, but they're not worthwhile for us, because if I try to be everything to everybody, then I end up being ineffective to everybody and not really get any traction in any channel.
Makes sense. One more thing for you. I've heard that Facebook is pay to play for businesses. Can you explain what that is, and is that really the case?
Well, it is, and every day seems to be a little bit more that way, that they are pay to play. We shared with you some tips on shareability, and there'll always be that organic part of Facebook. There'll always be that natural engagement of, oh my gosh, I want to share this because it emotionally did something with me. It did one of those things that we shared with you. It engaged me, it fulfilled me, it informed me, whatever that is. But know this, you know, Facebook is a public company. They're traded on Wall Street, and therefore they are beholden on quarterly results, and you have to allocate a certain amount of money to jump in that pay for play on the ads. Now, remember, they want you to be successful. They want those ad dollars to work. They just don't want to take your ad dollars. And it's still, at least at this point, it's still very reasonable, but don't think that you don't have to allocate some funds. You can, what's called boost a post for $10 and reach several hundred people. So it's not a large amount, but you do have to allocate some funds to be there now, and that's where they want you to be successful. That's where that business page and the blueprint comes in, and you can make $100 go a long way. And I love radio, I love other mediums that are mass mediums, and nothing wrong with those. $100 doesn't go a long way in that space. I can make $100 go a long way with Facebook, so you do want to allocate some funds for that.
Great, thanks for explaining that. Well, that's all we have time for today. I stand by my guru comments, and as we wrap up another edition of the Tuesday Morning Profit Break, remember that when your focus is on growing people will grow your business. We look forward to seeing you next week, 10:15 Eastern, for another great episode of the Tuesday Morning Profit Break. If you have any questions for Bart about today's show or any of us at the Education Department, or like more information, you can reach us, any of us, at education@bpaa.com. Also, you and your team can watch any of our previous episodes 24/7 by visiting bowlinguniversity.net. Until then, I'm John Karabatsis, and do for one what you wish you could do for everyone. We'll see you next week.